A mood for change has delivered former airline CEO Christopher Luxon a decisive election win, becoming New Zealand's next Prime Minister. It's a substantial political shift for the country, drawing a line under the historic rise and fall of Jacinta Ardern's Labor government.
From businessman to politician.
We will get this country back on track.
Christopher Luxon's most ambitious sales pitch has paid off.
New Zealanders listened to National, but more importantly, National listened to New Zealanders.
Earning him a promotion to the top job as New Zealand's next Prime Minister. His centre-right National Party surged to victory in the general election, inspiring a blue wave across the country and a bloodbath of high-profile Labor MPs.
I gave it my all to turn the tide of history, but alas, that was not enough.
It's a significant political shift for New Zealand, ending 6 years of favour with the left-leaning Ardern government, marred by the COVID-19 pandemic and rising costs of living.
I did know when I took on this job that it was going to be an uphill battle.
The National Party will form a coalition with New Zealand's ACT Party, but special votes may rely on Kingmaker, New Zealand First, led by Winston Peters, to meet the 61 required seats in Parliament. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese phoned his Kiwi counterpart to congratulate the win.
Anthony Albanese and I know each other well from my previous life. It's in Australia our most critical, most important relationship, and I want that to go from strength to strength.
While offering commiserations to Chris Hipkins on Twitter, to my friend, you have served your nation with distinction. The incumbent, in every sense of the word, defeated.
Finally, to my family, for everything that you have done for me.
Final results will be officially declared on November 3. Until then...
And I cannot wait to get stuck in and to get to work.
Jessica Maggio for 10 News First.
Pro-Palestinian demonstrations have also been held around the globe today as tens of thousands call for an end to Israel's military action in the Gaza Strip. There have been major rallies in cities in Italy, Germany, the United States and the United Kingdom. In London, protesters filled the streets calling for peace.
Prepare to come out in support of Palestine, of justice, in support of law, in support of what is right, in support of peace.
Demonstrations have been mostly peaceful, with only a few reported scuffles between protesters and police. France remains on high alert after two major tourist hotspots were evacuated over bomb threats. Visitors and staff at the Louvre and the Palace of Versailles, were ordered to leave as police searched both premises. Nothing was found. It comes during heightened vigilance in France following a fatal school stabbing on Friday by a suspected Islamic extremist. 7,000 troops have been deployed across the country to bolster security. British film legend Michael Caine has decided to step away from the limelight, announcing his immediate retirement. The 90-year-old star, who is known for many roles, including The Italian Job and the Batman trilogy, has told the BBC his decision was influenced by the type of roles he's able to be cast in, saying 90-year-olds are very unlikely to be the lead. It ends a 70-year-long career in which he won two Oscars and appeared in more than 100 films. Millions of Americans have had a front row seat to witness the rare Ring of Fire solar eclipse. The eclipse briefly dimmed the skies over parts of the US, Central and South America, lasting for only 5 minutes. It's a prelude to the total solar eclipse that will sweep the American continent in 6 months. A pair of rare Sumatran tiger cubs have put on a show for zoo visitors, stepping out to explore their habitat for the first time. The three-month-old siblings are the first born at the San Diego Zoo in 7 years. They are part of a global effort to boost the tiger population. Sadly, it's estimated only 600 remain in the world.